Hi there everyone, welcome to Temporal Paradox 1. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to crop your standard widescreen videos into that super widescreen cinema style that Hollywood often uses for their big blockbusters and seems to be becoming more and more popular just for any videographer out there when they want to create that real cinema style look. I was actually reading an excellent article on Wikipedia the other day. I've got a link for that article in the description box, and it lists the history of the different aspect ratios that the film industry has been using over the decades, because it's been changing all the time. But the one that we seem to be quite happy with at the moment is the 2.39:1 aspect ratio. Quite often they round that up to 2.4:1. So that's what I'm going to be working on with this tutorial. So how do you do the cropping? Well, you go into the Event Pan and Crop button on your video and make sure that Lock Aspect Ratio button is deselected. Make sure Size About Center is selected, and also Move in the Y Only position is selected. Then put the mouse pointer on the top edge and you can start dragging down. Now that's a very simple way that you can do it. However, it's not very accurate because you're only going by your eye. So what I've done for you is I've worked out the true dimensions to type in here manually, which will give you the precise professional measurements. So the measurement for 1080p video is 804 height, and obviously the width stays the same. Once you've done that, then you can save this as a template for next time. And I'm just going to put 1080p at the end of that description and click save. You'll understand why in a second. So that's the dimensions for 1080p. If you're using 720p video stock footage, so that's 1280 by 720, then the height's going to be different because the video is smaller. So your dimension to put in is 536. Now you have to create a different template because it's different measurements. So there's 720p, save that. If you're using 480p video, your measurement will be 358. Save that. And finally, if you're using 360p video, your measurement is 268. So there you go. There's all the measurements. So you just type that in. So next time you do a project and you dump the video onto the timeline, all you got to do is click Event Pan and Crop. And so that's 360p video. Do the drop down box, find it, and it crops it automatically. One final thing to know with using this technique is, say you shoot a piece of video that goes for 60 minutes, you put it into Vegas, but you have to chop it up. A really good tip is to make sure that you apply the cropping before you start chopping the video up. Because if you apply a crop to a video and chop it up, the cropping information is held within all the different pieces. Whereas if you chop it up first, Then try and apply the crop. You have to apply the crop to each and every single piece. So I hope that was helpful a little bit for you. Thanks for watching again. Thanks for listening. And I'll see you next time.